Hey guys, Danny here, back with another video. Today we are reviewing a smartwatch. This is the Umidigi UFit, and of course it was sent to me by Umidigi for review. As always, if you'd like to pick it up, you can find a link down in the description. And today I'll be discussing with you whether this watch is worth purchasing. My initial thoughts when handling the smartwatch and when I came to the end of my review was that the watch itself does feel of a decent quality. When I talk about the body, the button and the main body feels good, but the strap itself just feels and looks a little bit cheap to me compared to some others that I've recently tested, even ones that are cheaper than this product. The strap just feels a little bit thicker and more weighty than some of the other smartwatches that I've recently used. So it's a minor criticism, but these small details are very important when you're constantly wearing something like this. Secondly, while the display is of a decent quality, it doesn't quite get bright enough for my liking. Especially with other smartwatches using AMOLED displays now, this is lagging behind. So sometimes to get the best viewing experience, you do have to move to a shaded area. It's definitely not unreadable in bright sunlight, but again, it's just not up there with some of the other devices. Most of the features that you would expect are included. Additionally, there is also a blood pressure feature, which is not something I have seen before in a smart device. So I'm not sure how accurate this is, as I've used much more expensive smartwatches and they didn't come with this feature. So I'd be interested to learn more about how accurate this actually is. Unfortunately, beyond these standard features, this device is still suffering from the problems I had from the previous Umidigi watch I reviewed. And that is, it's lacking in the area of customization. The user interface could use a little bit of work, and also the companion app I feel can be a little bit messy at times and definitely does need some tweaking. Here's an example. You only have 4 watch faces that you can switch between by going into the settings menu. This really isn't enough, as most other devices allow you to customize your watch face and even download additional ones. Some even go as far as allowing you to use customized pictures. So it's just not really enough when you compare this to the customization and the options available in other products. The companion app called VeriFit Pro also I feel could use some work. Again, it doesn't have a ton of customization available to you, and some of the layouts that you have to navigate through when looking at your heart rate data, your sleep tracking data, and even your activities just feels like it could have been laid out a little bit better. Most of these points I am making are quite minor and they could be fixed with app updates or even firmware updates to the watch which are available, but these are small details that are not lacking in a lot of other smartwatches in the same price range, so it's really difficult for me not to mention them. While this watch is good in some areas, it's just not up there in terms of user experience and customization. So them reasons let it down, the same as the last Umidigi watch that I reviewed. After 5 days of light usage, I used up about 50% of the battery life, which is a pretty respectable number, but when you consider this doesn't have an always on display, the results aren't quite that impressive, but this is something that hopefully could be added in the future. And that brings us to the end of the video. I really hope you enjoyed the review. My final thoughts are that if you would like to pick up this product, it's definitely not bad, but I just think there are some better options out there that you should consider. And with some updates and some tweaks and fixes, this device could be a lot better in the future. So hopefully the developers will see this review and make some adjustments. As always, if you'd like to pick up this product, you can find the link down in the description. I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing for more videos like this one. And of course, I will see you in the next one.